Welcome our dear student of third prep in a new episode of Madrasa على الهوى. Today inshallah we are going to continue our lesson mirrors in the first lesson in unit 2. As we explained in the previous session, the property of the plane mirror and the image formed by the plane mirror, which is found in our homes. Okay, now we are going to explain the second type of mirror, which is called spherical mirror. So we have two types, plane mirror, we have explained it, and the second type is spherical mirror. Why we call it spherical mirror? Okay, why we call it spherical mirror? We call it spherical mirror because this mirror comes from a hollow sphere. We have a sphere which is hollow and this mirror is a part of it. If the reflecting surface, the shining surface, is the inner of this sphere, the sphere mean inside, we call it concave mirror. If the reflecting surface is the outer surface, we call it convex mirror. The two types of mirror, plane mirror and spherical. The types of spherical, convex and concave. What's meant by spherical mirror? They are mirrors which are part of a hollow sphere. We can see this mirror if we have a spoon, the spoon which we eat with it. Okay, the inner part, the place we will put the food, this is the represent the concave mirror. The back of the spoon is the convex mirror, like this. كده ال inner part concave, this is the outer part ال convex mirror. Okay, so we have now two types of spherical mirror, concave and convex mirror. If there is a difference between them, yes, there is a big difference between the two types of mirror. The concave mirror is the part of inner sphere and we call it converge mirror. While the other mirror is convex mirror and we call it diverge mirror. Type. Why the concave called converge and why the convex called diverge? The concave mirror collect the light ray. We see it in the last session that the light reach the reflecting surface and return back and reflect back. So the concave mirror, what will happen when the rays collect, when the rays return back, they collect in a point. So it is called collect mirror, all concave mirror, all converging mirror. The opposite in the convex mirror. It separate the reflected light will be in many direction, so we call it the diverge mirror. Okay, let's see together. Now, this is the definition of spherical mirror or what's meant by the spherical mirror. It is the mirror that its reflecting surface is a part of a hollow sphere. As we see the diagram, this is the sphere. Okay, this is the convex. The shaded part, okay, دايما ده الظهر المراية. The shaded part is the behind of the mirror. The reflecting surface is outside, so it is convex. The other one, the shaded part is outside, so the reflecting surface is inside, so it is concave mirror. This is opposite to this. This is outer surface, this is the inner surface, convex and concave. Okay, now we have the comparison between them, the type of spherical mirror, concave called converging mirror, and the other one is convex mirror called diverge. Okay, type. What's meant by concave mirror? It is, as we see from the previous diagram, mirror, its reflecting surface is the inner part. So don't mix up between them. Concave is the inner part. It called converge. Why it is called converging? Because it collects the ray after reflection. What about the convex mirror, diverge mirror? Its reflecting surface is the outer surface. It's diverge light ray after reflection. Okay, let's have this give reason. Give reason. Concave Mirror is called converging while convex called diverge. Let's draw the first. This is the concave. We must shade the behind so we know that this is the reflecting surface. When the light falls on the concave, they collect. Okay, so a concave collect the reflected rays. Let's draw the convex. Okay, this is the shading part, the behind of the mirror. Okay, this is the incident ray. What will happen? It separate. This will reflect like this, and this like this, and this is like this. So it separate the reflected ray. So this is called diverge and the other called converge. Converge means collect, diverge means separate, and this is the two mirrors we are going to have their property and the images formed inside them. Okay? In order to discuss the spherical mirror, we have to know some concept or principle in these mirrors. First, we explain that it's called spherical because it's come from a sphere. Every sphere, as we learn together, have a center. Again, the mirror is a part of a sphere. Each sphere have a center. This center is called what is called the center of curvature of the mirror. So what's meant by C, or the center of the mirror? It is the center of the sphere in which what? In which the mirror is a part of it. This is the principle or the concept we have to learn, or we have to know its definition. Now, when I ask what's meant by the center of curvature of a mirror, you are going to answer, it is the center of the sphere in which the mirror part of it. Okay, let's see together. Concept related to the spherical. Number one, center of mirror curvature, and the simple of it is C. The definition is, it is the center of the sphere that the mirror part of it. As we discussing the spherical mirror, so they are coming from a sphere, the center of the sphere. As we see from the diagram, this is the concave mirror, the shaded part outside, and this is the center of the sphere. It found in front of the concave mirror. What about the convex mirror? This is the shading part, here a reflecting surface, a center behind the convex mirror. As we said, the reflecting surface is the inner part, and the concave and the convex is the outer part. So the C will be in front of the concave mirror and behind the convex mirror. This is the first concept we have to learn. Okay. Number two, the pool. What's the pool? This is the reflecting surface or the mirror. Okay. From X to Y, as we see from the diagram. The midpoint, the point at the middle from X to Y, we call it pool or P. What's the midpoint in the reflecting surface? It is the pool. It is the pool. Pool of the mirror, what's meant by pool of the mirror? Or define the pool of the mirror, we're going to say, it is the point that is the middle of the reflecting surface of the mirror. It is the point in the middle of the reflective surface of the mirror, as we see from the diagram. Okay, if the reflecting surface, the mirror, is from X to Y, so the midpoint P بي البول is the reflecting on the reflecting surface is called the pole, the middle point. Okay, the other concept, number one we have C, the center, number two P, the pole, number three the radius. What's meant by the radius of the mirror or the radius of curvature are, okay, similarly as you study in geometry or in math, it is the radius of the sphere that the mirror is a part of it. Okay, let's have a look in this diagram. This is also the concave mirror. See, this is the center of the sphere. From the C to any point on the reflecting surface is called radius. The convex mirror, the same. See, this is the center of the mirror or the sphere from which the mirror part of it. A line joining between the C and the mirror, this is, we call it radius of the sphere. Okay, this is number three, radius of the mirror. It is the radius of the sphere that the mirror is a part of it. Okay, number four, principal axis. What's meant by principal axis? The principal axis, it is straight line, passes by the pole of the mirror. Type. What's the pole of the mirror? It is the middle point on the reflecting surface. The point middle on the mirror. And its center is C. The straight line, as we see from the diagram, at the point of C, what is P? مش أي نقطة. نقطة P اللي هي midpoint on the reflecting surface. If I make a straight line from the C of the B, this is, we call it principal axis. Type. The principal axis in the convex mirror, from C to B, this is, we call it the principal axis. Define principal axis. What's meant by principal axis? You are going to answer. It is the straight line passes by pole or P and the center of the curvature C. Again, remember principal axis. A line have to pass by two points, B and C, B and C. This is the principal axis. Why? Because we are going to see now the secondary axis. Is there a difference? Yes. It's also a straight line passing by C, but by any other point except P. The principal, you have to pass by P and C. The secondary, you have to pass by C, but another point except the C. Okay? But let's have explain the principle now. Number one, we said the C, center of curvature in the mirror. What's meant by C? It is the center of the sphere in which the mirror part of it. As we said that the concave or the convex mirror part of the sphere. يبقى C, center of the sphere, the part which they are come from. In the concave, the C will be in front of the mirror. In the convex, will be behind the mirror. Number two, we said the P, pole. What's meant by pole? Middle point. If we, this is the mirror, the middle point. If this curve, the, if it's 10 centimeter, the midpoint 5 centimeters. The point in the middle of this mirror is called pole. It's called pole. Okay, it is the middle point or midpoint on the reflecting surface. The principle number three, we said the radius. What's meant by radius? It's also, as we know, a mirror comes from the sphere. So it will be what? It will be the radius of the sphere in which the mirror part of it. Okay, from C to the reflecting surface. The principle number four, we call it a principal axis. Okay, what's meant by principal axis? It's a straight line. A straight line. Passes by what? Remember بقى كويس the principal axis. Line is يكون passing by the P and the C. What's the C? Center of the curvature. Will P the midpoint اللي هي إيه? The pole. يبقى the principal axis passes by pole and C. Principal axis passes by pole and the C. The pole, the midpoint on the mirror, reflecting surface, and the C is the center of the sphere. The last principle we have taken, secondary axis. The principle, straight line passing by P and C. Secondary axis, straight line also passing by C و any point except ال P. يبقى أي point except ال P اللي هي ال midpoint is called secondary axis. Okay, طيب when we think together how many principal axes and how many secondary axes, we are going to find that the mirror will have only one principal axis. Why? Because the mirror have only what midpoint, هي نقطة midpoint واحدة البول, وده ال straight line اللي passing by C will be. But secondary axis many or uncountable secondary axis. Why? Because I have many point on the reflecting surface except LP. طب what will happen though straight line passing by P? كده بقى ايه؟ بقى principal axis not secondary axis. Okay, let's see it together. Okay, number six principal focus او الF. Okay, this is the point of collection of the parallel ray. When the ray comes parallel, they reflect focusing in a point. This is, we call it the point of focus. Number six, focal length. What's meant by focal length? It is the distance between focus, LF, and the pole, LP. يبقى principle, our focus, el focus only is a point. El focus only is a point. طيب, focal length, distance. Because you are mixing up. دايما بنلغبط. الفوكس, the focus is a point of collection. Focal length, the distance between F and B. The distance between focus and the pole. Okay? As we see here, this is a concave. This is the parallel rays fall on the concave mirror. And all the light hits the mirror and reflect back in one point. This one point called what? Called the focus. It's a clearest, smallest image format. The distance between the pole and the focus is called what? Is called focal length, like this diagram. Okay? This is the example of a spherical mirror. As we said, spherical mirror has uncountable number of secondary axes and one only principal axis. Okay? طيب, how we can determine the focus of the mirror? We have two definitions, focus and focal length. Focus and focal length. Focus, a point of collection. Focal length, a distance from the focus to the pole. طيب, a simple, instead of writing the focus, we write F and the pole P. يبقى, the distance between the pole and the focus is called focal length. But how can I determine or calculate the focus or the focal length of the mirror? Now you can do it if we have a concave mirror at your home. You will face the mirror in front of a light source. And your concave mirror facing sunlight or a light source. Okay, and you will bring a screen. You can bring a paper or a cardboard in front of the mirror. And moving the screen forward or backward. يبقى ادي المرور facing the sun. And you are going to receive the image. Sun fall on the concave mirror, reflect on its surface and return on the screen. When returning on the screen, it will form. طبعا I'm moving back forward or backward. Until I obtain what point? Clearest, smallest image. نقطة. This point is the focus. This point is the focus. يبقى number one will bring a concave mirror. Number two facing sunlight. Why sunlight? Because it is a very far object, the sun بعيدة. So the light will fall parallel on the reflecting surface or the concave mirror. And we are going to move the screen. What's the screen? To receive the real image. To receive what? The real image. You are going to move the screen forward or backward till you obtain clearest, smallest image. Clearest, smallest image. Okay? And this clearest, smallest image is called the focus. طيب. By measuring the distance, يبقى الكونكيف هنا وهنا ال image formed dot نقطة or clearest, smallest image, the distance بقى من المرور to this image is called what? Is called focal length. Is called what? Is called focal length. Okay, let's see this experiment together. Okay, how to determine the focal length of the concave mirror? Number one, place a concave mirror facing the sun ray. Why? Because the object comes far away, so the rays fall parallel. As we see, parallel rays fall the concave mirror. Number two, move the screen. Okay, the screen in which we are going to receive on it the image. Until what? Until obtaining smallest and clearest image. Then measure the distance between the source or the point and the pole. The observation here, the rays after being reflected or collected, okay, this point is called what? Is called focus. That can be received on what? The distance equal half the radius, curvature, and it is called the focal length of the mirror. So the focus equal to what? Half the radius. So the focus equal to what? To half the radius. And what's the radius F we've seen? It is the radius of the sphere in which the mirror part of it. This is was an activity or an experiment to determine or measure the focal length. And from this experiment, we have a very important conclusion that the focus equal what? Equal half the radius. So the radius will be what? Twice the focus or the focal length. Twice the focal length. Okay. Let's have a diagram here. Focus, focal length equal 4 cm. So radius equal what? Okay, we have the rule, el focus equal what? Half the radius. Okay, so the when the focus become 4, so the radius will be twice the focal, so it will be 8 cm. Okay, we can make the rule focus equal half the radius, or radius equal twice the focus. If the radius 10, focus will be 5. If the focus 5, the radius will be 10. Okay, and how we can obtain it? By obtaining the clearest, smallest image of the back. Now, in order to draw the images formed by a concave mirror, we explain now the types of spherical mirror, concave and convex. And why they are called by this name, the concave because it collects, and convex because it separates or diverges the light ray. We have taken the principle of the spherical mirror. Number one, center of curvature. It is the center of the sphere in which the mirror part of it. Number two, radius. Radius of the sphere in which the mirror part of it. El pole, midpoint on the reflecting surface. Then we take principal axis, straight line joining between the pole and the center. Secondary axis, it is the line joining between the center and any point except the B. Focus, point of collection. Focal length, the length between the focus and the P. And we have an experiment to determine how we can calculate the focal length. The conclusion of this experiment that the focal length equal what? Equal half the radius. Okay, so if we said that the radius equal 10 cm, half the distance will be what? Will be the focus. لو 10 سنتيمتر يبقى الفوكس on what? On 5 cm. If the radius 20, so the focal will be what? Will be top. Think together. The diameter equal 20 cm. The diameter equal 20 cm. Okay, let's write this. Diameter 20 cm. So, radius will be what? Half the diameter, 10 centimeter. The radius, الفوكس what? Half the diameter, so it will be 5 centimeter. Okay, يبقى ادي السيركل. Okay, دي كلها 10 سنتيمتر. هنا 10 ودي 10، يبقى كلها 20. من هنا لهنا. النقطة هنا الفوكس half the radius، يبقى دي الاف، يبقى دي اللي هي 5 سنتيمتر، دي 10، والراديوس كله هو الدايمتر هو اللي ب 20. يبقى الدايمتر 20، half الراديوس 10، half الفوكس 5 سنتيمتر. اوكي؟ طيب we have a last give reason to take. We have only one principal axis but many secondary axes because the principal axis is the straight line joining by center and pole, and there is only one pole on the reflecting surface, while the secondary axis it is a straight line joining by many points except the pole. Okay, النهارده we have covered the spherical mirror, the principle, and how we can determine the focus and the focal length, which have a relation focus equal half the radius. Inshallah, we're going to continue how to draw the images and the uses of the concave and the convex and the difference of both of them. Okay, inshallah, until we meet next week to continue the mirrors. Thanks for your watching and goodbye. Thank you.